Miss Elfrida Uchechukwu Udebe, the patient that did surgery in Manipal Hospital. It was sometime April last year, 2019. I called my daughter. I said, go and sweep the staircase. She said, Mommy, my leg is spinning now. Quite unlike her, we sent her on an errand, she run and do it and come back. But I was shocked. Mommy, leave me, my leg is spinning. I left her, but I kept watching her. After 2 days, I saw she could not walk well. I took her, she did some x-ray. The result came out, they called it Osgood disease. So they now found out Manipal Hospital through somebody, through an Indian man in Nigeria. So from there, we met Dr. Freeman, who attended to us, counseled us, told us a lot of things concerning her. We now met Dr. Amit, who told us what and what we'll see in the treatment, the sections of the chemo.
She actually came with a pretty big tumor around her knee coming up from the thigh bone. The problem was that she came in with a 90-degree bent knee and with such a big tumor that she's not slept for the last 6 months, and she was basically suffering with pain and not even walking also for her basic needs. So we did the workup and we diagnosed her to have a high-grade bone sarcoma called as osteosarcoma, and this was only localized to the knee, surprisingly given the large size of the tumor, and there was no metastatic spread anywhere. So our team oncologist from Dr. Amit Rothan took it up and started her on intensive high-dose chemotherapy. And after 4 cycles, we found that the tumor had shrunk to a certain extent. And the challenge in these situations is that when someone comes along with such big tumors, they often end up with amputation. The chance of saving the limb is less than 10-15%. But we took it as a challenge based on the excellent response we got for her chemotherapy. Myself and our plastic reconstructive team, Dr. Srikant, took turns and we carefully removed the tumor from the normal tissue. And after removing the tumor, we reconstructed that whole defect with titanium metallic tumor prosthesis, which would enable her to walk literally from the next day.
Now, this cancer was limited to the leg and not spread to any other part of the body, but it was very large. So we took it as a challenge that we can shrink it, we may be able to save her limb and give her a good quality of life. We started her intensively on chemotherapy, every 21 days of chemotherapy, and we gave her 4 cycles of chemo. She responded very well and the tumor shrunk down very well and her pain also came down. Once we got good response, we have taken her for surgery. Dr. Srimant, Dr. Srikant and their team were able to do a wonderful surgery, removing the whole tumor and also preserving her leg.
Microvascular surgery involves the surgery of small blood vessels, typically between 1 and 3 millimeters. Very fine sutures are used, and using a microscope of a very high magnification, this anastomosis is done, attaching the artery in the vein, which is known as that as anastomosis, and this supplies blood supply to the flap. We were anticipating a lot of difficulty. Fortunately, things went on well. Yeah, the wounds healed uneventfully, and we were also managed to straighten her leg, which was bent. We have almost brought her leg to a near normal state. She is now undergoing physiotherapy and is able to walk on her own now.
Other procedures after surgery and every other thing, she did so well. And today we are happy. The leg is there, it wasn't amputated, and she can move with the leg. I really thank the doctors, especially Dr. Amit, Dr. Srimant, and Dr. Srikant.
My future plans, I want to become a doctor, because for a doctor to treat me of my osteosarcoma, I also want to help children of my age when I grow up to overcome this crisis. If there would be anyone who have this crisis, because I don't pray for anyone to have my crisis, because it is not easy. When I had osteosarcoma, I couldn't eat, I couldn't sleep, I couldn't drink, I couldn't walk. I was just lying down on my bed. But now, there is a big difference. I can sleep, I can eat, I can drink, I can walk, I can even dance. After my treatment, when I go back to my country, I would wish to go back to school, to sing in the church. I want to thank the nurses, the sisters, the brothers, the staff of Manipal Hospital doctors.